about 6:15. Getting ready to get out of here. Water in the back. Water. A little food, and this is where the camera's gonna go. And sky is overcast. And ground is a little damp because it rained. 6:15. Hey, jamming it to some Dave Matthews. I don't know if you can hear that. Take it all, it comes cheap. Push it through the door, zip between the lines. I'm gonna pack more lines, cause I can get them in. Ooh, traffic jam. Got more cars on the beach, got sand. Suck it up, suck it up, zip, suck it up, fill it up till no more. Oh yeah, baby. I'm not satisfied. Keep on growing. I eat too much. I ride too much. I want too much. Too much. Where I used to come in. Oh, the sun got him. Stomach don't stop it today. All right, going back to ride. Yeah, still got Dave Matthews with me. I think the album's crash. And it sure is nice to be out here right now. We'll see what I'm saying in about 5 hours. See if I'm pushing pretty hard, I have to admit. I have no idea why. Normally I can rationalize about 10 miles of warm up on a, you know, on a 50 plus mile ride. You know, save a little. Yeah, I started this ride out like it was a 2 or 3 hour ride. In which case I really don't need a real break on a 2 or 3 hour ride. But, okay, well, I don't know if we saw before the Volo water tower. Yeah, let's try to get water towers. Well, I can't read it, but I think that's Gilmer there, road. And yeah, we're coming up to our transition to crushed gravel. Yeah, might as well get the transition. Might be a little boring, but shitty. This is around 7 here, Labor Day morning. Been a few people out here, not too many.
It's like five dogs and five people, and you know, four or five deer. There's another bike rider. Got the right idea. Water tower, hope. Guess where I am. Yeah, nice homes and townhomes right along here. It's really pretty. The part through Volo back there is a little too high-endy for me. Bum 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 bum. Do 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 do. Soft. First legitimate stop here at this park that the bike trail now hooks into. I used to just kind of skate by it, and now they put in a tunnel. Which, if I was really sharp, I was doing something else when I went through the tunnel, so I forgot about the camera. But I know one thing I was thinking about is how that's the furthest I've ever gone on this trail without taking a break. I didn't check the time, but it's safe to say it's probably an hour-ish, and the time of an hour is real close, and it might be 11 or 12 miles by this point. This is the second to the last section before I get off these woods trails and get on the city trail. It goes along Holly. Anyway, I think it's pretty obvious that it's worth making an effort to get to this park. Really did a nice job. I'll pop out here. Stuff. Alright. Well, I missed the last time. I forgot this one was so close. I think it's the third one I've gone through. I don't know. It's nice though. It makes, when you do that, you totally don't even. And that was that Fairfield? Yeah, I just crossed under Fairfield and didn't even, it's like you don't even know Fairfield's there. So, see if this sign says something. Look at that. There they are. Yeah, I asked them if they'd stay, and I passed them. They were crossing the road there. Oops, left them.
Gotta make some general comments here that so far everything is performed really excellent. The bike's, you know, almost perfect. When it's not clunking, it's better than ever, but still does this clunking thing where I gotta fool around with the gears a little bit and then it comes back. Sometimes easy, sometimes medium easy. The new pouch on the front, it's all for shimmeled right now, but that whole foods bag that I just wrapped the strap around and taped it on there, that's what I've been keeping the camera in, so I can just reach down and grab it. There's also
food in there, and of course I had the my voice recorder MP3 player with the headphones with Dave Matthews to get the deal started. That was great. And everything, the way the bike's balanced weight wise. Got a nice little downhill for us to enjoy. Hopefully I can, maybe I can get this uphill too. Yeah, why not? Just a little cadence. A little cadence for you. Yeah, this is breaking out of the woods section. You can hear the road up there. This will just spill out onto Holly. Right up here. Okay. Yeah, it's worth seeing the sign. Yeah, we'll ride up to the sign. Mile zero. Another map. Well, we are on Plains River Trail. Past the 25 mile mark. Maybe about 26 or so here. Did not check the time. Yeah, I got this because of alkaline water, like a alkaline water regimen. My first leg and water bottle was green tea. See, green tea with cranberry. Then when I got to Holly, I began to eat. So that leg was for eating. And now, morning. Now when I stopped, I just downed a whole container, a whole water jug of water, and then refilled it. So now this is this leg, this 20 mile leg of this ride, I'm going to hydrate up and raise my pH. That means I'm at the 50-minute mark. Yeah, it looks like it does. All right, here I am, further north on, Plains River Trail. This is this spot where it goes along the railroad tracks. Got these kind of big puffy clouds, which are, my strap is broke. No way. Look at that shit. Looks like it's broke. I got a screw left. I think I can fix it. Maybe it's kind of cool I got to have a breakdown with the camera going. Because I was able to get out my tools and fix that. Like that. That's good. What are we? Approaching a 3.5 hour mark, which is very close to a third of the projected time of a 104 mile ride. Estimated time 10 hours. Starting at 6:15. Puts me home at 4:15. That's quite a ways away. Okay, signing off. Hello. I need a gear. Yeah, it's somewhere around the 40-mile mark. Don't know what that is, maybe 41 or can't remember the road, I mean, of course. Well, this is a really nice part of this park. Yeah, it was so nice back there, I realized I should be filming, but I just wanted to enjoy it. So this is old. You know, it's old trees. Also, this trail looks like it used to be, you know, like a road. And then they added the crushed stuff to turn it into this, or it's just how they made it back then. But not developed and not used like the rest of the Des Plaines River Trail. Yeah, pretty wildernessy here. Very nice. Yeah, I got the camera here so I can show somebody some horses. Uh-oh, I missed it. Yeah, I definitely don't know it up here. This is, it's only my second or third time up this far. I usually turn back by now. We're going all the way to Russell Road this time. About a mile away. All right, take the glasses off probably. Okay, well, this is Russell Road. Right over there is 173. See the sign. And that's, I just got done riding from the trail from, what do you call it, trail? Oh, I'm running out of tape. Okay, this trail here, that way is McDonald's. I might be stopping there later. There or Subway. And then it's like the noon hour, so it's still pretty busy. And this way north here to Genoa City, to just be in Wisconsin on this trip. Yeah, somewhere between 60 and 75 mile mark here. I'm kind of leaving it. No, 70. It's between 60 and 70 mile mark. So, don't really know for sure. Trying to keep it, you know, mysterious. Yeah, I don't know. I can see that. Yeah, I took a wrong turn somewhere.
I think Keystone. Keystone's the road I was looking for. And I think it must have a different name here in Wisconsin or in Genoa City. There was a... Ooh, chilly. Okay. It's about the 90... About the 90-mile mark. Just outside of Spring Grove. About to get into Fox Lake and, you know, finish it up. This is the water. This was full, and of course I had my water full. I stopped and got a cappuccino. So, you know, that's about an hour left. It's pretty close to perfect. And just got a little bit of munchies left. Okay, time to finish it up. Yeah, back in town.